Well, hi nerds. I have with me Mega Ran here right after the first show on the first leg of his new tour. Thank you for giving us time today.
No problem. Thank you for being here and for asking me to do this and being so patient with us trying to find a place to do this and having amazing questions at the ready.
I can't wait to do this interview.
We really appreciate your time and consideration here at Symphony of the Nerds. So our first question for you is, do you consider all of your projects passion projects, or do you do any projects based on your fans and what they want?
Wow, that's a good question. Honestly, everything is because I want to do it. I used to listen, I'm not going to say I don't listen to fans now, but I used to listen to fans a whole lot more back in the day. And I thought, and I feel like I maybe overdid, like, say, Mega Man projects, because I thought that that was what my fans wanted to hear. And it led to me kind of disappointing myself with some releases. Like, Mega Man 10, I did an album based on Mega Man 10. I didn't think the soundtrack was great, and I wasn't super inspired to make something great like I had been in the past. But yet, I wanted to see the project through because I started it. So, it's important to draw the line between, like, finishing projects that you start, but also making sure you make something that you're going to be proud of. So now, everything I make is a passion project. Unless it's like a Kickstarter or fundraiser type of thing where I'm like, hey, you can vote on what you want me to make. For Patreon, we take votes every month on what new games people want me to cover. And that's the time for the fans to be input. Patreon.com/bitsandrhymes.
Okay, next question. Do you ever consider collaborating with artists of similar content but outside of hip hop?
Like who?
There are lots of people on YouTube that do a lot of, like, anime-based and video game-based work. There's Amelie and They Wants to Battle, who are indie, like, pop rock. They're core artists who do small tours right now.
It's good that you mentioned Amelie. I'm actually about to collaborate with Amelie very soon.
Oh, wow.
So this is an exclusive drop. Boom. Bomb drop. In March, we are working together. We're doing some things at South by Southwest. And it's going to be really good. So myself and Amelie will be collaborating real soon.
Oh, thank you for the heads up.
You got an exclusive. I haven't told anybody that.
Oh, wow. Right here at Symphony of the Nerds. Since you've gone on a tour multiple times now and put a lot of energy into your music, do you ever think you'll go back to teaching?
Never. Almost said never, and you never say never. I would go back to teaching, but not in elementary school, public school, no. I would teach college, I would teach business school, a vocational school or something like that, but I wouldn't go back to a traditional public school system. I feel like the system needs a lot of work, and sometimes when you go in trying to fight something and you're in over your head, the broken thing can break you before you fix it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like being in a relationship with somebody that's broken. You know what I mean? And you're trying to fix them, but their negative habits wind up breaking you. You feel me?
That's understandable.
That's what public school is to me. It's a broken system that will break me if I go back to it. And, yeah, that's that.
Okay.
It needs work.
It is fixable, but maybe not by one person.
Yeah.
Definitely not.
These shades are about to close. This might have to be quick.
So our next question is, given your past licensing for your first Mega Man album, do you ever start projects hoping the game developer will reach out?
No, because you just wind up getting disappointed. I saw a great quote from Quincy Jones who said, when you try to make a project for money, that's when God leaves the building. That's, you know, you'll never succeed trying to make something for profit or for the money or for the fame or for the attention. It'll never succeed. If I said, oh man, let me make a Metal Gear project and hope Konami gets involved, it'll never be successful. That's the wrong motivation. Feel me?
Yeah, for sure. Okay. there were other artists, or of the other artists who are paying attention to you right now, who want to get into nerdcore music, what would you encourage they do to be successful? And do you think that what you did is still useful for people trying to get into it now?
Yeah. I've done a lot of viral projects that have gotten quick success, but I think being able to follow those up is what's made me successful. So I say find a thing you're passionate about, make a very good project or song or piece about that thing. Like Rick and Morty, you like Naruto, you like Star Wars, Guardians of the Galaxy. Find that thing you love and dig deep and dive into it. And then, if it's done well, people will notice it, people will respect it. And then you gotta be ready for the follow-up. And that's when you work on your original material that you can back that up with. So I still think that we're still in a society where viral content can be useful.
Okay. All right. Well, this is definitely the most intense question I have for you. Since there are a large amount of gamers who are queer and are women, and a lot of them might be into your music, does that affect the music you make or what artists you work with, since hip-hop has a long history of homophobia and misogyny?
It absolutely is a big thing that I'm trying to change. You know, I know that hip-hop has been rooted in homophobia and misogyny, and I make sure that that's nowhere near my music. And for that reason, of course, I would be open to working with anybody. And that's, and I want people to be comfortable in their own skin. And that's really what my music's all about, is, you know, here I'm, and not trying to equate anyone's struggles, but I felt like coming up as a black nerd kid who had terrible vision and thick glasses and was overweight with an overbite and, you know, was completely socially awkward, with ADHD and all these different, you know, things going on, it was a very tough road for me. And I feel like for that reason, I want to make sure that anybody realizes that I understand and I'm there for them. And I feel like, I've gotten so much support from the queer community, from I feel like so many different people, outcasts of all types, because we're all outcasts. And we have that in common, and because we have that in common, we can continue to understand each other and be there for each other. That was a heavy question.
Thank you for your honest and thoughtful response. Okay, and the last question we have for you, what's your favorite album of yours so far, and what's your favorite track you've made so far?
That's not your favorite song.
So your favorite song is your favorite song. I didn't think it was my favorite song. But Dream Master is probably my favorite song I've written, because I feel like it's the Mega Ran story in a nutshell. You know, beginning, middle, and end of where I am. And it's even at the end, that part, the best part comes at the end, but that part hasn't been written yet. So it just it has a life beyond when I sat down and wrote it, which I think you can't script that, it just happened that way. My favorite album is probably the album that's on, which is Forever Famicom, which is an album that myself and Kate Murdoch did. I feel like it was one of the first times where the production really challenged me to do something and be something special, and realizing the power I had within these songs and this voice, and trying to use it for something really powerful. I noticed people like when I tell stories, so therefore I took storytelling through video games, which is where I learned storytelling, and tried to build something new out of the things that have raised me and shaped me. And that's why Forever Famicom will always be a super special album to me.
Wow, we really appreciate the time you've taken with us and all your really great responses, especially considering the tour that's starting up literally hours ago. Yeah. I'm glad you were able to make the time out, and I really hope you have a lot of success in all your tours and life.
Thank you so much. Same to you and to this amazing show.
Thank you.
I will continue to support it, and everybody that's watching and listening should also do the same. Smash that sub button
and like or comment. Thanks, nerds. See you later.